We're back with another video, and tonight I'm gonna be explaining a little bit. I'm no expert in this topic, but I will be explaining what I know and what I have read, and I'll also be putting some pictures and some other diagrams explaining the differences between an Old English Game Bantam and Azteca Bantam. But the main difference in them is the wing carriage and the foot size difference. Just want to show you guys the Aztecas that we have right now. And I'm gonna also show you what our Old English looked like next to them. So right now we have that brown red cockerel out there. And you guys can see this is one of our barred cockerels. And you guys can see already the size difference in these two guys. So he had to get up there to get close to his size. Okay guys, and just how I told you, I will be showing you guys some diagrams to help me explain to you guys the differences between the Old English Game Bantam and the Azteca Bantam. So this diagram basically shows us how the back of the Old English must have a U shape with saddle feathers flowing into the tail. The weight must be from 570 grams to 680 grams. That's a pullet to a full grown cock. The tail must be held at a 45 degree angle with the wings tight, neat, just past the stern and almost horizontal. A round, broad and prominent chest with a slight S curve from back to neck. Top of the head should be level with the top of the sickle feathers. And this is just a bit of the descriptions that I was able to find. Full descriptions will be on later on in the video. I was also able to find one for the Azteca Bantams, but it was in Spanish, so I took my time to translate that for you guys. It basically says the tail must have a slight drop with a U-shaped back. Tail in the form of a fan with a 60 to 70 degree angle tail. 14 to 16 feathers, and head must be level with the sickle feathers as well. Always vertical. Sickles, 6 to 8 feathers, slight drop, and symmetrical. The weight must be 350 grams to 450 grams. Wings must be at a 45 degree angle, proportional to the body type, and wings must cover legs. Leg size must be 4.7 centimeters thin, and scales must be nice, symmetrical. The breast must be compacted and well balanced. The head must have a water drop silhouette, balanced beak, curved, clean snap, and symmetrical to the head. And here in just a second, it's showing you guys the picture of the two birds that I just explained to you guys. At the bottom, you have the Azteca, and at the top is the Old English, and you can see the two birds side by side. Here in just a bit, I will be showing you guys birds that I have, so you guys can see the two differences of the birds live. And that was the full description from the ABA, and here are some other pictures to help you guys explain the differences. Hope you guys enjoy the rest of the videos. All right guys, so now we have our pumpkins. We're getting ready to show you the difference in sizes in our pumpkins. You guys can see the leg sizes in this guy. And as I was showing you guys earlier, the wing carriers, they're wanting to push their wings forward. Unlike the Old English, I'm going to show you guys a pumpkin Old English over here. Well, right now he's wanting to throw his wings forward because he has another one in front of him. But, you know, you got like the Old English, they usually carry their wings real nice and tight. As opposed to the Azteca. Oh my God. Look at you, dude. You're molting and everything. Come on. Look at that, guys. But you guys can see the leg size differences in them. guys. Just wanted to show you guys the size differences. And the Aztecas are actually much lighter too. If you guys can feel this guy, he's actually a lot of feathers. They're not supposed to be weight. I think they're wanting them from 350 to 450 grams. The head shape on the Azteca is supposed to be like a water drop, unlike the old English. You know, they kind of have that slope, slanted haircut like we talked about in the previous video. But yeah, guys, just wanted to show you guys the differences between the old English and the Azteca Bantam. Here's our old English. He's starting to molt. And there's our Azteca. You guys can really see how short these guys are in comparison to the old English. Okay, guys, so now we have one of our BB Golden hens. And then we have it right next to one of our golden pumpkin hens. You guys can see the leg size differences between the ladies and even the body size differences in them. I just try to trim up her beak a little bit. That's why she's kind of trying to catch her breath back again. You guys can see the leg size differences. I would show you this other lady that we have in here. She's another one of my shortest girls, but she's actually, if you guys can see, she's a bit occupied right now. And we have her with her mahogany dad. He's molting really bad right now, but he's a three-year-old cock that we're still that I've been line breeding for the past 2 years, 2 to 3 years. I think I got him when he was a year old or 6 months old or something like that. But I've been line breeding him, just trying to get them smaller, smaller and smaller. But yeah, guys, just wanted to show you the size differences in the ladies. And just like the other one, you guys have seen a video of this one. She's actually like 308 grams. I just wanted to show you guys the differences in the birds that I have. I'm sure there's better quality birds out there that can show you better. But somebody was asking me about it, so I decided to make a small video about it. This girl right here, she actually went sitting on three eggs that was hers, and then I took some of this lady's that I just put up and put under her. But I think when I put them under her, they were still too early, and he didn't have the eggs fertilized, so she only managed to hatch two of them. And she's also a mid-sized leg Azteca. She's a different bloodline than the other ones, but she just hatched those two. And I wish I could show you her leg size and her body size and everything, but she's got two chicks under her, and I don't want to really bother them right now. But yeah, guys, I appreciate you guys watching. Thank you guys. Catch you guys in the next one.